Good evening, dear students. In the series of microbiology lecture for Sandhan, today we are going to learn about a very important topic which affects the daily life, and that is biodeterioration. To discuss this particular topic and give you the information about the topic, I am Rakesh Patel from R.G. Shah Science College, and with me is Professor Kiran S. Trivedi from the same college, R.G. Shah Science College. We are going to discuss about a very hot topic, that is biodeterioration. Now, the first thing, what is basically biodeterioration? Now, biodeterioration, if you want to understand, then just look to the title which is there displayed on the screen. On the left hand side, there is a sculpture, there is a statue which is covered with certain moss and algae. And if you see it again on the screen, then on the right hand side of the screen you have a building. It seems that this building is very old, and there are certain algal patches on the building, doors, walls and all these things. Now, this is something which gives us an impression that both the materials, either the statue or the building itself, is not maintained properly or it has deteriorated. So basically, the deterioration means any substance or any material which changes in a way that there are certain undesirable properties which are observed on it. That is, if you define biodeterioration, then we can say that any undesirable change in the properties of a material caused by the vital activities of the organisms. Here the word organisms nu matlab em nahi thato ke fakt bacteria. There are many other higher forms of life also which are responsible for bringing about such undesirable changes, and that undesirable change which occurs in material, in that particular substance, is known as biodeterioration. In other words, you can say that it is either a physical or chemical alteration of a product which ultimately leads to the decrease in usefulness of that product for its intended purpose. E je vastu jena je vastu nu je kaam hoy e kaam ma athva to ena function ma ena outlook ma ena dekhav ma kai pan undesirable changes aave jethi karine e vastu nu value ochi thai jaye ene apde biodeterioration kahishu. Okay, there is a similar word which is known as a biodegradation. Now, biodegradation basically is the similar kind of activity, but these activities are ultimately leading to the product more useful or acceptable. So, the activities of organisms will be there on the material, but ultimately it is going to be of some help to human beings. It is a useful activity, or it is an acceptable thing for human beings. Now, this is because these degradations are essential, and they are the means of recycling of many essential elements which are contained in these materials. Abhi hum ek example aapko bataun ki, for example, let us say that you have purchased the new shoes, leather shoes from the market. Now, these leather shoes, basically you have purchased it and you are going to wear it. Now, when you have gone out in a rainy season, and if these rainy shoes gets wet, and if you keep it aside for a few days, within few days there will be a growth of fungi, either aspergillus or something like a penicillium, as a result of which there will be formation of some patches on the shoes. Those shoes are new shoes, you are still using it, and as a result aaj ye shoes je bagdi gaya ene apne shabd vaprishu biodeterioration. Pan e j vastu, e shoes જ્યારે આપણે ખૂબ પહેરી લીધા હોય અને ફાટી ગયેલા તૂટી ગયેલા શૂઝ આપણે ફેંકી દઈએ, ત્યારે જ્યારે એ એન્વાયરમેન્ટમાં સોઇલની અંદર એનું ડિગ્રેડેશન થાય, જેથી કરીને એ શૂઝ, એ લેધર, એના એલિમેન્ટ્સ ફરથી પાછા અર્થની અંદર ભેગા થઈ જાય, ત્યારે આપણે એને કહીશું બાયોડિટોરિયરેશન. સો યુ કેન વેરી બી યુ કેન બી વેરી ક્લિયર દેટ બાયોડિગ્રેડેશન ઇઝ અ વેસ્ટફુલ એક્ટિવિટી, ઇટ લીડ્સ ટુ સર્ટન લોસ, વાઇલ બાયોડિટોરિયરેશન ઇઝ અ યુઝફુલ એક્ટિવિટી વિચ ઇઝ એસેન્શિયલ, અધરવાઇઝ ધ વર્લ્ડ વિલ બી ફુલ ઓફ વેસ્ટ મટીરિયલ્સ. સો ધીસ ઇઝ ધ ડિફરન્સ બિટવીન ધ ટુ, બાયોડિગ્રેડેશન એન્ડ બાયોડિટોરિયરેશન. You should understand that organisms are more or less the same, as well as the chemical or biochemical activity shown by these organisms on this material is also essentially the same. Okay, now let us classify the biodeterioration. Biodeterioration can be mainly classified into four different categories. First is physical or mechanical, second one is aesthetic, third one is assimilatory biochemical biodeterioration, and the fourth one is dissimilatory. So we have got these four different kinds of biodeterioration. The first one, pehlu prakar che, physical or mechanical biodeterioration. The basic thing is, in this the organism simply disrupts or distorts the material by growth or movement. Here organisms, they do not use the material as a source of food. Examples are so many. Let us take one or two. First one is, whenever a microbiological masses like algae, fungi and other organisms, they or lichens also, they grow between the rock layers or the crack between the two layers, this leads to spalling, or that is breaking of the surface of these rocks. That is one example. Another example, as you can see in this figure, it is a ship, and on the ship you can see here that there are various mollusks which are attached here. The things are more clear in the next figure. Again, a ship is there whose portion which is always immersed in the water is covered with certain kinds of sea creatures. This is a propeller on which there is a growth of certain organisms. Now, what does this indicate? This is basically nothing else but the presence of these organisms on the ship. As a result, there is some damage which occurs to the ship. It leads to the efficiency of operation. It leads to the more fuel consumption, and it leads to what we call it as a drag. Similarly, the second kind of biodeterioration is a physical or mechanical biodeterioration. This is due to the activities of certain higher organisms. For example, cracking of ground pipes by tree roots. When the tree grows and if there are underground pipes, it may break them. Similarly, biting, that is gnawing of rodents. They chew the pipes, they erode the pipes, or they sometimes eat away wires, cables, as well as the wooden materials which are dipped or which are buried into the soil. Third example is, which is very commonly there in the news, a bird strike on an aircraft. All these examples clearly illustrates that biodeterioration is not necessarily caused by consciousness processes of the organisms. It means it is not done intentionally, but it happens naturally. Okay. Then the another kind of biodeterioration is aesthetic biodeterioration. Aesthetic biodeterioration means the very presence of the organisms is objectionable. It is not needed, though it may or may not harm, but the very presence of these organisms. ઓર્ગેનિઝમની હાજરી જ એ વસ્તુની અંદર આપણને ખપતી નથી, અને એના લીધે જે ડિટોરિયરેશન કહેવાય એને એસ્થેટિક બાયોડિટોરિયરેશન કહેવાય. એક્ઝામ્પલ્સ જે આપણે જોઈએ તો કીડા, મંકોડા અથવા તો પતંગિયા એના મોલ્ડ કેસીસ અથવા તો એની ડ્રોપિંગ્સ, એ બધું જ્યારે કોઈ પણ સબસ્ટન્સ ઉપર પડ્યું હોય, ફોર એક્ઝામ્પલ ફૂડ ઉપર, તો એ ફૂડ સ્ટફ ભલે ખરાબ ના થયો હોય, આપણને એમ લાગે કે આપણે એને યુઝ નહીં કરી શકીએ. સિમિલરલી મેની ફંજાઈ દે ઓલ્સો રિલીઝ સર્ટન સોલ્યુબલ ઓર ઇનસોલ્યુબલ પિગમેન્ટ્સ વિચ ડિસકલર ઓન એજિંગ. લાંબા સમય પછી એના સ્પોટ્સ ત્યાં રહી જાય છે. એવી જ રીતે ઓર્ગેનિઝમ્સ વિચ ગ્રો ઓન સર્ટન મટીરિયલ્સ વિચ આર નોટ ડેમેજ એઝ સચ, બટ દે ગ્રો દેર બાય યુટિલાઇઝિંગ ધ સરફેસ ડસ્ટ ઓર ડેટ્રિટસ, એઝ અ રિઝલ્ટ ઓફ વિચ ઇટ અપિયર્સ ટુ અસ દેટ ધીસ મટીરિયલ ઓર ધીસ સબસ્ટન્સ હેઝ લોસ્ટ ધ એક્સેપ્ટેબિલિટી, ઇટ હેઝ લોસ્ટ ધ વેલ્યુ. સો ધીસ ઇઝ these are the examples of what we call it as a aesthetic kinds of biodeterioration. Similarly, the presence of organisms on certain compounds, certain materials, which we commonly call it as a biofilms, these biofilms are commonly found even naturally on teeth, as well as they are found on medical implants, as well as on the ship hulls. All these things which are considered as aesthetic biodeterioration. Other examples includes the presence of some organisms on building materials, presence of organisms on in pipes, as a result the flow is reduced, the presence of organisms on heat exchanger tubes which reduces the heat transfer. Similarly, certain oil in pipelines, they may organisms the presence of organisms may block them or corrode them, and as a result the flow is disturbed. All these materials are included what we call them as a aesthetic biodeterioration. The third kind of biodeterioration is assimilatory, that is a biochemical assimilatory biodeterioration. In this, it is because of the microorganisms, they use these materials as a food or energy sources. Microorganisms metabolize these materials, they produce the enzymes, and these enzymes they break down the complex compounds present in that material to simpler ones, or what we call it as they oxidize them. As a result the material deteriorates. For example, the presence of these organisms and their enzymes which breaks the cellulosic materials either in textiles or on papers. Similarly, the presence of rats and insects which eats away the food grains, the insect larvae which consumes the fruit, that is the fruit is soiled, and certain materials, for example hydrocarbons, fuels, oils, adhesives and many more. It is very difficult to imagine a substance which cannot be utilized by microorganisms. Microorganisms can virtually use every substance as their food materials given an appropriate time. Hence, you can say that all materials can undergo a biodeterioration by microorganisms. So these are basically the deteriorations which we call it as a assimilatory, where the organisms use this material as a food. And the final one is disseminatory biodeterioration. Disseminatory biodeterioration means here the food is not being used as a source of food or energy, but still, because the organisms produce certain compounds, these compounds like acids or certain volatile compounds, certain gases, as a result the material or the substance get damaged. These includes, for example, excreta waste products by organisms, for example pigments or certain acidic compounds or certain fouling gases. These all things can bring about certain chemical changes, certain damages, or they disfigure the materials. This type of biodeterioration usually goes parallel along with the chemical assimilatory biodeterioration and the biofilm developments, and the effects are so that it is very difficult to differentiate whether it is a biofilm or it is a assimilatory biodeterioration, or it is a dissimilatory biodeterioration. Now, once we have seen the different types of biodeterioration, let us discuss in general the biodeterioration and its control. This topic is going to be further discussed by Kiran Ben. Thank you, madam.
Now, dear friends, as you understand that from the previous discussion, you will come to know that biodeterioration is basically not a very good process. It is a rather harmful process. And any process which is a harmful, it should always be controlled. Hence, we can definitely say that biodeterioration, which of different kinds of material which occurs, it is a harmful process, and hence it should be important for us to control the biodeterioration. Now, the point arises is that how it is possible for us to control the biodeterioration. Naturally, the control of biodeterioration can be achieved by the direct application of Liebig and Shelford's law. This law says that the adjustment of environmental conditions to exceed the growth requirements and tolerance ranges of microbes to prevent the potentially destructive microbial growth. In other words, we can definitely say that we have to control or we have to adjust the environmental conditions in such a way that the potentially dangerous microorganism responsible for biodeterioration should be prevented from the growth. Now, again, the point arises, what are the different ways and means with the help of which we can prevent the biodeterioration or we can control the biodeterioration? There are physical and chemical methods with the help of which we can control the biodeterioration. Let us first have a glance at the physical methods of